this video, I'm going to recap some of the main messages and give you some practical tips for success. So point number one, it's important to write learning goals and objectives. If you've got nothing else from this online module, hopefully you've gotten that point. And the important thing is don't keep them in your head. Actually write them down. So by definition, a learning objective is what a student should be able to do after instruction. It should be measurable, and it does reflect what you value in student learning. So remember our car analogy. Learning objectives give us that target of where are you going, and then the student prior knowledge lets us know where we're starting at, and then we use instruction to bridge the two and help students get to our goals and where we want them to be. We've also got these different scales of learning outcomes. We have broad course scale learning goals and then more specific topic level learning objectives that are aligned across the course. So now we know what learning objectives are. When practically do you actually sit down to write your goals? Ideally, it would be during those weeks before class starts, right? But of course, this can be tough to do.
I think sometimes, too, it can just be hard to get started. Like, you know, kind of intimidating, think about the topic and then taking the time to write out your learning objectives. Sometimes I think that can feel like, do I have time to spend writing out my learning objectives? I have this and this and this and this to do to prepare for class. But I think that it is really valuable to have those learning objectives, and it really makes these other things go much easier. And it guides you in preparing all of these things, and so it's worth that investment. But I think sometimes that can be a challenge for faculty to feel like it's worth the time.
Right, like maybe it really has to be done in advance. I think if you're doing it right before you're about to go teach your class, it's too late.
Yeah.
You can't do it that close on to the instruction. Well, you can, but it may not be effective. I think you have to have thought about it ahead of time because you want to align everything else to it before you get to the class.
But if you're teaching a new course, I have found it's pretty hard for me to do that, to sort of look in the summer before a course that I've never taught before and think about the learning goals. Because I'm sort of figuring it out along the way.
Yeah, that's true. So you might have some big scale goals, right, but maybe the smaller objectives you kind of have to accumulate as you go through.
Yeah, I think for us, the first time we went through the class putting in learning objectives, we did kind of unit by unit, kind of unit learning objectives, and that would cover several topics, and then we did the next unit of learning objectives.
I did it that way too, because I think to do the whole course at once was way too overwhelming. It felt like a laundry list of too many objectives.
You also don't know what students are bringing into your course too. So, I mean, when you're learning, you know, they're building on their knowledge that they already have. So you may not even know what that is.
That's right.
And you're creating objectives that are reasonable for them.
Appropriate, yeah.
It's really important to write your learning objectives before you teach that course for the first time, if you have the opportunity. Once you have your instructional materials, you're not going to want to go back and redo the course. So look at, where are the tough spots for students? When you're preparing your lecture notes, where do you pause and have to think about things? Those are the bits that are sticky and important, and so you might want to focus your attention there. And then, once you teach it once, you'll be able to revise your goals.
At the end of a course, when I've just finished teaching it, I go back and try to rewrite the goals of that course. And what I use as evidence for that is what students reflect at the end of the course they say that they've learned and gotten the most out of. And then the next time I teach it, I look at the goal I just wrote and say, well, does that still make sense to me? Do I have some new ideas? Have I learned something about student learning since then? Or what might be a better goal to aim for this course? Has my department changed its focus? So I look at it again, and I do that before I do anything else, before I write assessments, before I design instructional activities to help meet those goals.
So do give it a try, writing your learning goals, even if you have to revise. If you have taught your course before, one thing you can do is start from your exams and work backwards, and that ensures then that your goals are actually measurable. So second point, it's important to have learning objectives that are clearly defined and appropriate for your students. So this is where you want to think about how to unpack a topic and think about where your students are going to struggle, which is difficult for you because as an expert, you've forgotten what it's like not to know the topic. So you can unpack the components of a topic or a goal in several different ways that we mentioned before, and you can also look at several different types of knowledge that you want your students to have. And then you can use Bloom's taxonomy to help you dial in to the appropriate level of understanding. And then once you've done this work of unpacking your goals, you repackage it together into your learning objectives. So point three, it's important to have learning objectives that are useful, realistic, and attainable by your students. Is it something that your students can actually do? Does the level actually match your expectations? Have you written something that's too low or too high?
It's really important to write well-defined objectives if you want to have a coherent course. A lot of the times, the course may seem coherent in our minds, but again, we're coming from the position of an expert, someone who already knows this terrain really, really well. So for your students to understand the course in a really coherent way, it's really important that you get those learning objectives really refined and that they're building on what students know already.
And here's that checklist for helping you to refine your objectives. Now, fourth point, be choosy. You know, make sure that your objectives are really focused on the things that are core for students to learn, and this will help to keep your syllabus really focused. Point five, use your objectives to design your assessments and instruction using backwards design. So remember, backwards design is where we define our objective, and then we decide on our assessments. And it can be helpful to brainstorm what an acceptable answer would be on that assessment to really make our objective concrete. And then our final step is that we design the instructional techniques. And the process of having our objectives, assessments, and instruction all work together is called alignment. Now, another practical tip. When do you refer to your objectives? Let's hear from a couple of instructors.
I refer to the learning goals when I'm lesson planning. I'm trying to design a lecture, and I'm thinking, what activity should I do today? What clicker questions should I ask? What's the number of topics that I'm going to address today? And then looking back at the learning goals reminds me. I've had some earlier moment of calm when I thought about those learning goals as part of a larger whole rather than the focus on tomorrow's lecture. So that's certainly a useful time to look back at the goals and make sure that my lectures are consistent with the bigger picture and with the most important ideals that I had in mind.
So one place I find it really valuable to use the learning goals is when I'm designing the homeworks and exams for the course. So for a particular week, I'll have tried to cover some learning goals in the class. And so then as I'm writing the homework around those goals, I really kind of try to make sure that each homework problem is doing something towards helping students achieve that goal.
Now, you also don't want to lose sight of the broader context of your department and your institution. So remember certification requirements or what students are going to need for the next course, or keep in mind your colleagues' expectations and their ideas about what the course is about. So I hope you've gotten a lot from this module on learning objectives. I just want to say that I've always been really surprised by how helpful faculty find learning objectives once they're developed.